Hey everyone, the name is Erik, and today's question is, what is worse? What is really worse? The existential angst that all intuitives have, you know, that real burning question, why am I here? What is my purpose? What is my truth? Who am I? Or the primal, real fear of being a sensing personality type and having a lifestyle or a goal or an ambition or something that's very important to you that you wanted all your life that you fear somebody is going to take away from you. How do you deal with that very, very real fear that you might lose your job, that you might lose your home that you've had for all your life, that you might not make it in the career you want, that you might not survive or keep your job at the workplace you love? You know, what is more real? And I ask this question because when I see intuitives, what I see is doubt, pure doubt, constant doubt of everything, doubt towards everything that is said, everything that is done, everything that could possibly be said or done. Intuitives doubt everything. Maybe I said something I shouldn't have. Maybe I did something wrong. What if I would change that? What if I would study this? What if I would go into that career instead? What if I would move there? What if I would live in that place? Would I be happy? What if I chose to do something else with my life? With intuitives, existential angst is the key most real problem and the most real driving force, you know, the driving force of change. I call anxiety the driving force of change. It causes us to throw up our lives, to uproot ourselves, to move forward, to go to new places, to try new things, to spread ourselves out, to learn new fields, to explore different opinions, to change our minds, you know, to challenge our thoughts, to challenge our ideas, and to see what survives and what is real. Fundamentally, what is real? Who am I really? What is at my core? If I question everything, if I question the very basis of my existence, if I take away everything my parents have told me about myself, if I doubt every little decision I made in my entire life, what is there left? So today's question is, what feeling is truly worse to have to carry with you? You know, the feeling that you never will know anything about yourself, that you will never truly know what you're meant to do, that you will never know your purpose, that you'll never find your way, or that fear that, yeah, I know my way, I know my purpose, I know who I am, but I'm not going to be allowed to do it. I'm not going to be allowed to succeed. The world is going to get in my way. Society is going to take it from me. I'm going to lose. I'm going to miss out. I'm going to fail. What I always tell intuitives that they don't like to hear is you're more sensing than you think. You'll have areas in your life where you have absolute certainty. And you'll have areas in your life where you have absolute doubt. You'll have things about you that will be very clear and very consistent to you throughout most of your life. You're going to have routines that you're going to stick to, and you're going to have chaos, a certain amount of chaos. Nobody can escape it, not even the sensing personality types. Life has an element of chaos and uncertainty to it. And that's why most sensing types are more intuitive than what they think. They are more intuitive than what they think. They are better at using intuition than what people assume, and they use it more often and sometimes better than intuitives do. So what you gotta find out is, what areas in my life am I absolutely certain about, and what areas in my life am I absolutely in doubt about? What you'll find is you have a core personality or something very consistent about yourself, or some consistent hobbies or passions or relationships or friends or something that is very important to you. Perhaps you're extremely family oriented, despite the fact that you travel a lot and that you go to a lot of places and that you made a lot of changes in your careers. You've been very family oriented and you've always been there for your family, and family has always been very important to you. If people call, you've always showed up, and if you've had a problem, you've always been quick to confide in your family and to seek their help and advice. And when they've given you advice, that you've listened to it very much. You've listened to it very strongly. Or perhaps you're an ISTJ or a sensing personality type, and you've had that you have those routines that you stick to, and you have those areas where you are very sure of yourself and things that you would never question, things you would never doubt. But you also have those things, you have that side to yourself that's a bit more creative, a bit more predictable, a bit more rare, a bit more odd. You have those weird eccentricities that other people don't have, you know, those crazy things you do that, why do I do it? That make no sense, you know, that those things that make you into a literal UFO to other people. And those are your intuitive quirks, you know. We all have them. Everyone has some of these intuitive quirks, you know. And it's almost even more adorable in a sensing personality type. You got the that ISFP that is very much a hard worker that's always been very much strong in their passion and what they've done and who they are. But they also have those weird quirks, you know, those things that are a bit wishy-washy. Sometimes when they talk and they open their mouth and it's like, weird. Wow, what are they saying? What do they mean? What are they doing? Those sides to themselves that are a bit more crazy, a bit more odd, unpredictable, that change from time to time, from day to day. And similarly, intuitives have those, what you could call boring elements, you know, those elements of themselves that are very much familiar and will always be familiar and will always be predictable. You know, even if you're an ENFP, you're going to have some areas where you're very predictable, and you're going to have a balancing aspect to yourself, something that is grounding you, something that's giving you stability. I mean, this is something important, you know. If you were completely intuitive, you would be in a lunatic asylum. You would be hid away from the rest of humanity. You would be too dangerous to be allowed to exist, because there wouldn't be anything real about you. There wouldn't be any core quality of you. You would be completely the joker of society. You would be the complete joker of society. You would be the complete wild card, the one that could change their job in any second, move to a new place, do something, break a moral law, hurt somebody just because you felt like it, just because you got that whim. But you don't, you know. You have those grounders, and everybody has those grounders, you know, those things that keep them real, keep them sane, keep them healthy. And you need to balance out your grounders, you know. And that goes for being a sensor as well. You know, when you're a sensing personality type, you have that very real fear that, people are going to take my job. I'm going to lose it. I'm going to fail. I'm not going to make enough for my rent. I'm going to fall behind. I'm going to miss out. I'm going to be late. I'm going to pay my rent too late. I'm going to get fined or wrecked or thrown out or, you know. And then it's important to have that basic intuitive grounding mechanism. And that's going to sound really weird for an intuitive to hear this. How can intuition be grounding? Well, intuition can be liberating. Intuition can be like air to earth, something that gives freedom and lightness to being. You know, so what if I lose my job? I'll get a new one. So what if I lose my home? I'll get a new place. So what if I'm late by a minute? I will find a way. I will find a way forward. That's grounding to a sensing personality type. That realization that there is nothing to worry about. In the greater whole, everybody has lost a job. Everybody has been late sometime. Everybody has lost something. Everybody has missed out on some party or some action or some activity. Everybody has had days where they've been hungry or stressed or tired or sick or something like that. And, you know, we've helped each other out and we've gone through it. And the stronger our security nets are, the stronger our bonds to our family are, and so on, the more we'll dare to spread our wings and the more intuitive we'll allow ourselves to be. It's not an end-all or be-all game, you know. It's not either I commit myself 100% to my ideas, no matter what, no matter if I end up living in a van, no matter if I end up losing my job, no matter if I end up cutting off myself from all my relationships, until I succeed. It's that I have my friends, and I have my family, and I have my bonds, and I have time. I have all the time in the world. I know realistically that I'm going to live until I'm at least 60 years old. You know, most people are. So I know I have the time, and I know I'm not in a rush, and I know I'm, if I can give myself that minute to breathe and to enjoy the flowers and to be present and to take the moment as it is, I'm going to be happier and I'm going to be more healthy in my intuition, and my ideas are going to be brighter and less dark and less extreme and less grim and less impossible and less heavy to carry. Because, yeah, I'm going to have people who have my back if I fail, and we all need that. So, what are you? Are you the intuitive marshmallow that struggles with anxiety and constant second-guessing and doubting, or are you that sensing type that struggles with absolute fear of how do I live? How do I survive? How do I make it? How do I keep my relationships? How do I make sure my friends are happy? How do I make sure that I'm happy? How do I make sure that I feel good and healthy? You know, what type are you, and what are your grounders, and what are the things that keep you sane, and what are the things that keep you balanced, and how do you manage the interaction between sensing and intuition?